Have you ever wondered how pilots know the speed of the aircraft they are flying? It turns out that airplanes do not rely on GPS or satellite navigation systems to measure their airspeed. Instead, they use a simple yet crucial device called a pitot tube. This tube is responsible for measuring airspeed, which is essential information in aviation. In this video, we will discuss how the pitot tube works, why aircraft need it. The pitot tube is a small tube-shaped device mounted at the front of the aircraft, or on the side of the nose. It was first invented by a French engineer named Henri Pitot in the 18th century, and was originally used to measure the velocity of water flow in rivers. However, in aviation, the same principle is applied to measure the speed of air flowing into the aircraft. The pitot tube consists of two main parts, the total pressure tube and the static pressure tube. As the aircraft flies, air enters the pitot tube, and sensors inside detect the pressure difference between moving air and stationary air. This difference in pressure is known as dynamic pressure. By applying Bernoulli's equation, the aircraft's computer can calculate its speed based on this pressure difference. However, it is important to note that the speed measured by the pitot tube is not the aircraft's speed relative to the ground, but rather its speed relative to the surrounding air, which is called airspeed. In early generation fighter jets, the pitot tube was often placed at the nose of the aircraft to avoid airflow disturbances around the fuselage. However, as technology advanced, modern fighter jets, such as fifth-generation stealth aircraft, prioritize aerodynamics and stealth capabilities. Therefore, many pitot tubes are now relocated to the sides of the aircraft's nose, or designed in an L-shaped pitot tube to ensure accurate data collection without interfering with aerodynamics. Despite its simple appearance, a pitot tube failure can be catastrophic. History records several incidents caused by blocked or faulty pitot tubes. One of the most well-known incidents was Air France Flight 447 in 2009, where ice-blocked pitot tubes resulted in incorrect airspeed readings. As a result, the pilots lost control and the aircraft crashed into the Atlantic Ocean. Another case occurred on Malaysia Airlines Flight MH-134, where the aircraft had to return to the airport after the airspeed indicator failed. The reason? The pitot tube cover had not been removed before takeoff. To prevent such incidents, all parked aircraft are fitted with pitot tube covers. These covers are usually bright red, with a long ribbon to remind ground crews to remove them before flight. Additionally, modern aircraft are equipped with pitot tube heating systems to prevent ice buildup during high-altitude flights.